Hello, Archbishop Lazar. I have a couple questions for you. You have consistently maintained that the doctrine of the aerial toll houses is Gnostic. And I think there is evidence showing that there's definitely some kind of Gnosticism here. But my questions are, why don't you attack the soft panentheism in Orthodoxy, which we find taught, for example, by St. Gregory Palamas? He also had Stoicism, Stoic elements in his theology, according to Dr. Constantine Kavarnos. Okay, so there's some Stoicism there, which is a pagan philosophy. And he held to, I guess, what is now called soft panentheism. And panentheism is different from pantheism. In panentheism, the universe is inside of God. So basically, panentheism, whether soft or whatever, is a pagan philosophy. The oldest forms of it go back to Egypt, I think 14th century BC. And it's found in the Hindu Upanishads. It's found in Jewish Kabbalism. It's found in Hinduism, Buddhism, and even some traditions of Wicca. This is a thoroughly pagan concept. So why do you uncritically accept the panentheism in Orthodoxy and do nothing about it, even though it's completely and thoroughly pagan, but instead you attack the aerial toll houses? So you're not being consistent. Also, I'd like to know why you don't attack the whole concept of icons. The first people in church history who used icons were the Gnostics. Okay? You can look at a dictionary of early Christian doctrines by David Berceau. He discusses this. There's also a video where he briefly mentions this. So the first records we have of iconography is found in Gnosticism. And the first records we have of panentheism is found in Egypt and Greek philosophers, by the way, too. I didn't mention that. Plato and Heraclitus. So these were first found in pagan sources. So why aren't you going after panentheism, and why aren't you going after iconography? If you're going to be consistent, then you have to do this, okay? So these are my questions, and I thank you for listening.